Challenge accepted. Let's rock and roll. Till death do us part. Rock and roll. Challenge accepted. Challenge accepted. Let's rock and roll. Let's rock and roll. Challenge accepted. Let's rock and roll.
Start your work day at 8 o'clock p.m. Right. And then your work day is over at 2:30 a.m. The high notes, the steamrollers, the socialites, and finally, the Vogues. Let's get into it.
This is Bank It. As usual, our eliminated players will explode into coin showers, but this time around, those coins can be picked up and banked. Plot twist.
Available for our cash-hungry teams. Just locked in some earnings. Good job.
Cover's here. Yo, hello.
Yo.
And just like that, a new vault has appeared in the arena.
Can I get help, man?
A few more coins in the bank for the Vogues. Trees, but a new vault just appeared in the arena.
A contestant from the Steamrollers is particularly rich in coins right now. To bank or not to bank, that's the question.
A contestant with a lot of coins just became a lot less liquid. They've been eliminated.
Reposition here. There, go! Go to Vault 5, everyone.
Is ready to be opened. Me, oh my! A contestant just banked a minor fortune for their team. Has been taken down, spilling a wealth of coins in the arena.
Someone from the Socialites is loaded, but remember, in Bank It, heavy pockets can quickly become empty ones.
Get Vault 1!
I love this part of our show. Who will get to the new vault first? The Steamrollers are truly rolling in it now, with their coin-by-coin plays leading to victory. On behalf of our sponsors, thanks for tuning in.
The enemy is the other side. Man, you see this Mark Zuckerberg? That's your first stand-up. You have
the powerhouses, the shock and awe, and finally, the ultra rares. The arena's calling.
Welcome to Bank It, a coin hunt where contestants will crack open vaults and pilfer downed opponents. But the real race is getting those coins banked securely.
It makes no fucking sense.
A new vault! Our contestants better not leave that unattended for too long.
Bro, how about reviving us, man?
That's a deposit from the powerhouses.
Bro, go for the revive, bro. Casual nature in which these motherfuckers are shooting people is crazy.
Cling clang in the bank with a bang. Well done, the retro.
I cannot get my.
Is particularly rich in coins right now. To bank or not to bank, that's the question.
An eliminated contestant just left behind a huge pile of coins. Just bank some coins. Ah, I love the smell of a fresh vault in the arena.
Teams need to get ready to shift their game plan because a surprise is coming their way. To come with an explosive goodbye.
What? I just hate the zoom. Why is the zoom so stiff?
As our Dead Go Boom event remains active, our contestants can still offer a less than genuine ta-ta for now. if they are eliminated. Coins scattering absolutely everywhere after that elimination. Wow. Contestant with deep pockets just got eliminated.
Someone from the shop in ore is loaded. But remember, in Bank It, heavy pockets can quickly become empty ones.
On me! Come on! Storm Vault 1!
Full up with coins has just been shown the door.
One member of the Ultra Rares is jingling louder than a cash register. They've become a moving treasure trove and a potential jackpot for rivals.
A new vault just appeared. Let's see who grabs that cash. With a power-packed performance and precise plays for every coin, the powerhouses emerge victorious. On behalf of our sponsors, thanks for tuning in. Now, the Steamrollers, the Vogues, the Jet Setters, and finally, the Kingfish. Watch closely, folks. They're ready.
As usual, our eliminated contestants will burst into a pile of coins. But here in Bank It, those coins can be picked up and deposited. Finders keepers. We've got our first elimination, so it's time for both teams to put their best foot forward and their best
Don't
shot.
Feel like this.
I hope the viewers at home are ready for a wild ride. A new vault! This is going to get very interesting, very fast! RPG en route!
Transfer confirmed for the steamrollers. Coins banked. Creating a safe zone. Sending a rocket.
Slow and steady from the Vogues. Nice deposit. The Vogues just banked some coins. Oh, look! A new vault is ready to be opened. Drip, drop, the kingfish don't stop. That's a deposit.
Thank you.
contestants better not leave that unattended for too long.
Someone from the jet setters is loaded. But remember, in Bankit, heavy pockets can quickly become empty ones.
A contestant is down, and they're leaving a whopping cache of coins behind.
Someone from the steamrollers is loaded, but remember, in Bankit, heavy pockets can quickly become empty ones.
We might need a bigger bank. A contestant just made a jaw-dropping deposit of coins. And just like that, a new vault has appeared in the arena. Change is good, especially in the back. Nice move from the bugs. Change is good, especially in the bank. Let's move from the jet setters. We're halfway through the match, and I bet the sponsors are impressed with the play so far.
The action is quite remarkable, and it's fascinating to think about how the sponsors may have contributed to it. It's time to see what event will try to knock our contestants off their game. Time for our contestants to keep moving, as our laser is online and will dish out some serious damage to anyone standing still.
Don't shield them!
The jet setters just banked some coins. The kingfish swam to the top and banked their coins for the win. On behalf of our sponsors, thanks for tuning in.
Thank you. from me as a person, whether you like me or you don't. If you take this from me, you will be a better person. If you decide today that person, whether you like me today, that you're gonna live every day like it's your last for real, which means have a conversation with yourself every night that, okay, that was it. May not be no more after that. And really count yourself every day like this could have been it. All right. Before I go to bed, this could be it. All right. How's that looking? If you can do that, it'll change up. So about the Comedy Store and Fat Tuesday, where he said that Steve and Cedric and Kevin Hart and Tiffany Haddish came through there and made all lies. Steve and Cedric never performed at the Comedy Store at all.
The Overdogs, the Vogues, the Jet Setters, and finally, the Boundless. The stage is set. It's showtime.
There, go!
The arena's set for Bankit. Contestants will plunder vaults and snatch coins away from eliminated opponents, then deposit their earnings in the pursuit of victory.
There is another vault available for our cash-hungry teams. Jet Setters! Just what the doctor ordered, another vault!
Thank you.
Shields up.
But that's really how it is. I'm so pumped that that's how it is.
To fight for in the arena. Every coin adds up. Good bank by the overdogs. Coin counts. Nice deposit by the Jet Setters. The overdogs showed us that their bank is even stronger than their bark. A fantastic victory on behalf of our sponsors. Thanks for tuning in.
So basically, I think that was all pretty much responses. We had Tiffany Haddish, she was like slipping here. She was like, yo, I'm not mad. I just wish you would get a snatch right now. Damn, I guess I would send a reminder to this. But are we sure that's Cat Williams? He looks more like Trump's than okay. That's enough said. Let's move on to some other things. We're going to get to Blueface, and then we're going to also get to Ja Rule. But we got to get to YNW Melly, and also his own YSL cooperation. First and foremost, congratulations to YNW Melly's mom. I don't know what he particularly thinks about her in the OnlyFans, but after multiple kids, you know, I think she's in her 30s, maybe approaching 40s, she launched an OnlyFans while her son is in jail. Now, I'm going to be honest with you, and to her credit, she never said, hey, I'm going to use this money to fund legal expenses. She didn't say she's about to use this money to put on his books. She just said, y'all be up in our business so much. If y'all want to see more of me, because y'all keep saying I look good, y'all can come to the OnlyFans. And her name is Jamie, and basically, or Jamie, I believe, Jamie. Jamie put out the OnlyFans. And she then said later in the interview, which I just want to play that interview, she said in the interview that she made $40,000 on her first day on OnlyFans. This is also, you know, we could contrast this with FBG Duck Mom OnlyFans. Like, she said she made $35,000. She said she made $35,000, right? So she made $35,000 her first week. Then Melly's mom made like $40,000 the first day. Unfortunately, this is the reason why, like, you know, I like watching these days. Maybe I watch like these IRL streams. I love them. I know my son, Aiden, live streams from time to time.
He said my son.
Everybody knows about Neon. A woman that's dealing with a man, like a woman and a man that seemingly are now sharing the spotlight, is about who gains more from it. Some people say, well, listen, well, when you have a girl in your videos, people tune in more. Okay, and I always say, that's like minuscule to what she's going to gain if she ever comes out. For example, look at this, right? Like, you know, for example, Sam and Neon. Like, Sam got only things. Neon doesn't really get donations like that. He's relying on people to tune in. Well, what gives you the most amount of money, though? People who are going to subscribe with hard cash or they're going to view whatever they want. So if you subscribe with all cash, hard cash, she's probably maybe making more money than Neon, but I don't know Neon that big. Here's the thing when I'm connected to this. The moms, like, place, I personally believe, like, for example, XXXTentacion's mom, you know, she made $100,000 for this game. Again, the thing with the hip-hop's audience, right, and this is why I've never really collaborated with women who do OnlyFans, is because, intuitively, my mom created OnlyFans. I have
YSL gang member to young city deal in December 2022.
Stephen testified he had argued.
It's a music label, so music happened first.
Prosecutors pressing Stevens further on what YSL means to him.
I committed crimes while being a part of YSL, so.
YSL what? You understand that?
Yes.
I was fucking muted? No. Tell me that.
You guys just got back online, nigga. I was just looking on my friends list to see if this nigga's online for that long. And we about to get on right now after this game. Like, what the fuck, Potty? We was trying to play Dying Light early, but we didn't even get on because you wasn't on.
I've been on for like an hour.
What? Matter of fact, no, I haven't checked in the last hour. I was checking the whole night, though. But niggas been on since 12, bro. Oh, it wasn't 11, all right. Oh, like 12. The D spot, you popped out mad. Nigga, we could have been playing Dying Light or type of shit, nigga. Niggas, how about the last minute?
Yeah, I'm about to get off, man.
Basically, bro, this was our last game, bro. I'm tired, bro. Niggas up since 12, right, 11.
Just hit me out tomorrow, man.
All right, bro.
I'll catch up. This shit crazy, man. This nigga goofy as fuck, man. Some goofy ass fucking niggas, man. Oh, man. We took a nap so we could play tonight. But now we're going to sleep. What the fuck, man? I'm telling you, man. Niggas be bullshitting.
Gang hieroglyphics that might make some sense to you. Okay, we have the blood gang. Okay, you've heard of blood crimps, blah, 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 like whatever other gangs. Blood's a really big gang, right? Under blood gang is a very popular section that their blood, but this is their section. It's called sex, money, murder. Okay, so blood gang, sex, money, murder. Under sex, money, murder is YSL. So what happens is, they're saying this nigga, Young Thug, and I think maybe another person, founded YSL. It folds up under sex, money, murder, and bloods. Alright? Keep in mind what trial this is. This is a charge and a trial for enforcement of charges under the Georgia RICO Act that enforces gang criminal activity. So, you gotta prove the people in the gang. They got the co-founder here. So now, the co-founder, after they got all their people, different whatever with the gang. They got the co-founder of the gang, and now he's going to tell you whatever.
True, man. I only get time for like 20 minutes, so I'd just be wasting my time in another way. This wasn't happening before. They must have fucked something up in an update.
Here's the problem, man.
Sure.
I've been telling you, Atlanta is a home of the snitches. Atlanta has the most dedicated, like the snitches. I mean, there's more. You gotta remember, New York City got like 10 million people in it. Okay, so if you find five rats, okay, yeah, big deal. But Atlanta don't even got like 2 million. Like, they just got rats galore. Everybody's telling. Atlanta is the home of the cooperants. It's the headquarters of the truth tellers. It's where everybody who's run around with a Draco been incriminating, been robbing people, do not take responsibility. They get on the stand and blame it on the other guy. That is Atlanta. I'm sorry to tell you. Atlanta ain't no gangster haven. Atlanta is the home of the cooperants. If anybody from Atlanta says otherwise, I have the stats to prove it. I got how many people live in y'all towns or live in the greater Atlanta area. And you gotta tell me why y'all got so many cooperatives compared to New York, compared to Detroit, compared to California, compared to Idaho, compared to Mississippi, compared to Alabama, compared to Florida, where I was specifically, compared to any of these Johnny. Johnny, yo, like, if they had their whole little thing going on, he had not. And listen, if you're going to tell, at least be a great person and tell me, I've always been good at it. See, in school, oh, gold star, I think I was the best person in my class. I'm the smartest nigga, period. Anything I do on the bench. If I'm going to tell, I'm going to be the best type. You can't tell me. My thing with Atlanta is they're on the women.
Like three times already, if
step by step, that happened that night. Thank you. You wrote these pages in the dark place. So why are we finding them here?
I think I wrote them. I remember writing an endless amount of pages. When this happened before, the pages were being sent from the dark place to help me. Maybe the same thing is happening here.
That's all for now, Mr. Wake. Thank you for your cooperation.
Writing an endless amount of pages. When this happened before, the pages were being sent from the dark place to help me.
The pages we've been finding are from a horror story called Return, written by Alan Wake. And the contents of this book are coming true. Why couldn't it have been a romance?